Hey there, friends. It is me, Mike Harmon, or HLModTech, and I'm here with part two of Tinkercad for Teachers, and I'm going to show you how this can be used in your classroom to make what I'm going to call a digital diorama. Check it out. All right, friends. So let's start by hitting Create New Design. This project is going to be about designing our very own beach destination. We've learned already how to move and adjust and click from all the different locations. I'm going to get mine at a combo front view. I want to make a fun island destination. I'm going to do that by bringing out the half sphere. I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to drag one corner so it's quite large. I'm going to grab it and move it where I want. And then I'm going to make it really short. So I could just do it by hand. I could also type a number like 4. Since this is going to be my beach island, I'm going to change it to a beachy color. I'm going to do this light brown. And then I want my island to have 2 chunks of island. So I'm going to do the awesome duplicate command. And I'm going to pull it over to the other side and make it a little higher. And then I'm going to do Control D, which is the other shortcut for duplicate. And I'm going to pull it up in front and I'm going to make it a little lower. This wonderful little island is now going to get grouped. So I just grabbed a box that selected all of them and I have grouped it. Now in your classroom, this technique can be used to talk about any place that you've read about, some place that is historically significant, but this is where you get students started and then cut them loose to make something awesome. I also like to focus on the basics, like naming a file. So let's name this beach, and I'm going to put my initials after it as you should put yours as well. My beach needs an umbrella, and I'm going to build it with that half sphere again. When I bring the sphere out, I'm going to hold down shift and make it the size I want my beach umbrella to be. And then I'm going to duplicate that, and I'm going to make it a different color for a moment, just so I can tell which is which. And then when I pull it aside, so I'm just pulling this over, I'm going to hold shift and make it a little smaller. So let's check. My initial size was 42, so I'm going to subtract at least 4 from this so that there's 2 millimeters on every side. So I'm just going to hold shift until it says 38 or something close to that. I'm going to make it a hole then, and then from the corner, I'm going to look up and down. I'm going to grab both of those pieces, so I've just made a box that touches them both. It'll say 2 shapes are selected, and I'm going to align them. I want them to be aligned from the front, and I want them to be aligned from the left. And then if I switch to the front view, I want to make sure that they're aligned on the bottom. If I look underneath my project, you can see that they are now at the same level. And I'm going to take them since they're grouped, and I'm going to hit the amazing group button. And now I've got an umbrella that is actually hollow on the inside. It seems a little tall, but that's fine. I can just click on that height choice and I can shrink it so it looks more like the umbrella shape that I want. I'm going to move it over to my beach and I'm going to use the cone to lift it up. I'm going to bring out a cylinder to make the pole for my umbrella. Let's look at one of those top corner views. And I'm going to hold shift and I'm going to shrink it till it's the right size for my project. If I hit fit view to selection, it's easier to see it. I want it to be round, so I'm going to make its sides many, many. I don't care about the bevel, but I am going to make it a dark brown. I'm going to zoom out, so I'm going to hit the home view, another awesome tool to use. And this is a little tricky, but I want to find the up and down size, so I'm going to stretch that up nice and tall. If you're ever unlucky and you grab the wrong one, you can just use undo. And I can scroll in to make my life a little easier as well, as I try and find that and stretch it up. Looking at it from the right side or the right corner was a great choice. When I've got my umbrella stick the height I want, I'm going to move it over to my umbrella, and I'm going to use another technique where I hold shift and I click the wooden stick and then I click the umbrella so those two shapes are selected, and I want to align them center and center. So with them both selected, notice it says two shapes, and I can hit group to help them combine into one shape. You'll notice they change to one color. I can switch that by hitting the multicolor option. My umbrella looks pretty cool, but of course we should tilt it. If I click somewhere else and click on it, it gives me the normal rotation skills. I'm going to switch to a corner so I can see it a little better. That's the rotation I want. If I move away from the shape, it lets me do 1 degree at a time. If I'm close to the shape, remember it snaps to the 45 and 22 and a half degree adjustments. Let's add one more fun thing quickly before I cut you loose. I'm going to show you how to type text. When you bring that box out, just put the words you like. I'm going to put sunshine because it makes me smile. When you get that in there, you can pick the color you want it to be. I'm going to do yellow because that makes sense. You can shrink it after you type it to any size you want. I'm going to move it to a location I like. I'm going to look at it from the corner because that lets me use that cool rotation. And I can put it however I want. I don't mean to put it upside down, so I'm going to flip that back. And I'm going to just rotate it close using the 45s. I like that better. So I've taught you quite a few things right now. I would like to challenge you to add cool things like maybe seashells, maybe use this trick to make a pail using the cone. I will show you quickly that when you bring out the cone, if you change the top radius, that's how you can make it look like a pail in just an instant. I don't want to give you too many instructions. I just want to cut you loose and see what you can make. If you need some tips, call me over and I will hook you up. You can add questions and comments down below. Anything you think I should have added, just let me know. And I hope you have fun building something cool and incredible in our Tinkercad digital diorama. If you enjoyed this movie, please hit that like button. If you have any questions or comments, make sure you leave them down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Mash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit the notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HL Mod Tech.